Welcome to the BE lecture series. Now we are going to see the first unit, which is the electric and magnetic circuit. So first point is EMF. EMF is nothing but the electromotive force. So what is that electromotive force? It is the source of electrical energy due to which an electric current flows through the circuit. So for example, battery is the source of electrical energy. So if we connect the battery across any conductor or across if we connect that battery to any electrical circuit, due to the voltage present in the battery, the current flows through the circuit. So the voltage due to which current flows through the circuit, that voltage is called as the electromotive force, okay, because that voltage is the source of electrical energy. So what we have understood with EMF is nothing but the source of electrical energy due to which electric current flows through the circuit. Okay, so if you see in the diagram, one battery is connected across the conductor. Okay, so there is a flow of electrons towards the positive terminal of the battery. So why these electrons flows through that conductor? Because battery has one positive terminal, okay, and there are electrons in the conductor. So each electrons has a certain charge, okay, and that charge is a negative charge, okay. So there is a charge present on each electron which is the negative, and there is a battery having a one positive terminal, okay. So there is always attraction between positive terminal, or there is always attraction between positive charge and negative charge. So due to the attraction force between positive and negative, those electrons starts moving towards the positive terminal of the battery, and as there is a flow of electrons, we can say there is a flow of electric current. Okay, so as the voltage present in the battery, okay, there is a force of attraction between electrons and the positive terminal of the battery. Result of it is that there is a flow of electrons, or there is a flow of electric current. Okay, so battery voltage is called as the source of electrical energy, or it is called as the electromotive force due to which electric current flows through that conductor. Okay, so electrons always flows from negative terminal of the battery to the positive terminal of the battery, but we consider the current direction from the positive terminal of the battery to the negative terminal of the battery. Okay, and unit of electromotive force is the volt. Okay, so what is electromotive force? Electromotive force is the source of electrical energy due to which electric current flows through the circuit. And example is the battery, or the voltage we received from the MSCB. Next one is the current. What is the electric current? Current is the flow of electrons. And each electron has a certain charge. So electric current is nothing but the flow of electric charge. Okay. And what is the definition? It is the rate of flow of electric charge per unit time. So I is equal to dq by dt. Notation is letter I, and we can measure the current in ampere. So all of you know that we can measure the electric current in ampere. It is the unit of current. So what is 1 ampere? If a charge of 1 coulomb flows through the electric circuit in a 1 second, then it is called as the flow of 1 ampere current. So to understand the concept of current, it is very simple. What is electric current? Electric current is the flow of electrons. As each electron has a certain charge, electric current is nothing but the flow of electric charge. And there is one standard definition, technical definition, which is it is the rate of flow of electric charge. Whatever is the rate through with which electric charge is flowing, that rate of flow of electric charge is called as the electric current, and it is I is equal to dq by dt. How to denote it? It is denoted by letter I. How to measure it? It is measured with ampere. And what is 1 ampere? If a charge of 1 coulomb flows through any circuit in a 1 second, then it is called as the electric current of 1 ampere. If a charge of 2 coulomb flows in a 1 second, it is 2 ampere. If a charge of 3 coulomb flows in a 1 second, it is a 3 ampere. So that is the basic understanding of current. What is the potential difference? It is the difference in the electric potential at any two points in an electric circuit. Okay, if we measure the potential difference at any two points in it, any two points in the electric circuit, then it is called as a potential difference. We can understand with this figure. There are two containers, container A, container B. Container A has a higher level of higher liquid level, container B has a lower liquid level. It means that container A has the higher potential energy, and container B having a liquid which has the lower potential energy. Okay, if you open the tap, the liquid in container A, which has the higher potential energy, starts flowing in a container B, has a lower potential energy. Okay, so there is a energy difference between container A and container B, which is the potential energy. Okay, in the same manner, there may be a potential difference in any two points in the electrical energy. It means that there may be a difference in the electric potential, okay, in two points in the electric circuit, which is called as the potential difference. Okay, so unit of potential difference is the volt. And what is 1 volt? If a unit positive charge moves from a lower potential to the higher potential, requires energy of 1 joule, then it is called as the potential difference of 1 volt. Okay, so understanding of potential difference of 1 volt is very simple. Take a unit positive charge, starts moving it from a lower potential to higher higher potential. If energy required is 1 joule, then the potential difference is called as the 1 volt. So, if you want to move a unit positive charge from a lower potential to higher potential, if energy required is 2 joule, then the potential difference is called as the 2 volt potential difference. If you want to move a unit positive charge from lower potential to higher potential, required energy is 3 joule, then the energy required is the, then the potential difference is called as the 1 volt potential difference. So understanding of potential difference is that if we, it is the difference in the electric potential at any two point in the electrical circuit, and it is measured in the volt. What is electrical power? Electrical power is the rate at which electrical energy is transferred through an electrical circuit. So, if we measure the rate at which electrical energy is transferred, that measurement of rate of electrical energy, rate of transferring of electrical energy, is called as the electrical power. Or electrical power is the rate of doing work, okay, and which is measured in watt and represented by letter P. So, P is equal to voltage into current. So, we can measure the electrical power by multiplying voltage into current. Okay, so we have understood what is electrical power. Electrical power is the rate at which electrical energy is transferred through the electrical circuit. So that rate at which electrical energy is transferred is called as electrical power. And simply, electrical power is the rate of doing work. Okay, electrical energy. So basically, we know there is one universal rule about any energy. So energy cannot be generated and cannot be destroyed. It simply converted from one form to the another form. Just like electrical energy cannot be generated. Listened the electrical energy generation. So, it is against the universal rule of energy. So, electrical energy cannot be generated, but it can be derived or it can be converted from some another energy. So, what is electrical energy? Electrical energy is energy derived from electrical potential energy or a kinetic energy of charged particles. Okay. So, what is electrical energy? Electrical energy is energy derived from electric potential energy or a kinetic energy of charged particles. Okay, and E is equal to power into time. If we multiply electric power with time, we get the electrical energy. So, electrical energy can be measured with the by unit watt hour or kilowatt hour or megawatt hour. Okay, so whatever is the energy bill we receives from the MSAB. Okay, which bills indicates the electrical energy in a kilowatt hour. And what is 1 kilowatt hour? 1 kilowatt hour is the 1 unit. Okay, so energy bill has the energy you consume in a kilowatt hour, and measurement given that इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी मेजरमेंट इज ऑल्सो गिवन इन ए यूनिट. ओके एंड वन वॉट इज वन यूनिट, वन यूनिट इज इक्वल टू 1 kWh. ओके सो हाउ दैट किलोवैट आवर यूनिट बिकम्स और हाउ वी कैन से द एनर्जी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इज मेजर्ड इन किलोवैट आवर बिकॉज इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इज द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ पावर इन टू टाइम. सो पावर हैज़ द यूनिट ऑफ किलोवैट एंड टाइम हैज़ द यूनिट ऑफ आवर. सो दैट यूनिट बिकम्स द किलोवैट आवर. ओके सो विद दिस वी हैव अंडरस्टैंड द इलेक्ट्रोमोटिव फोर्स. सो इट इज़ द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी ड्यू टू विच इलेक्ट्रिकल करंट स्टार्ट फ्लोइंग. एग्जाम्पल इज बैटरी. करंट इज द फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स और इट इज़ द फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज. एंड लेटर इज आई, डिनोटेड बाई लेटर इज आई. इट्स यूनिट इज एम्पियर. पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, यूनिट इज होल्ट. इलेक्ट्रिक पावर, यूनिट इज वैट. एंड इलेक्ट्रिक एनर्जी, यूनिट इज किलोवाट आवर. सो विद दिस वी आर गोइंग टू स्टॉप हियर.